We have that for the projectile motion. If you look at a projectile motion, okay, you have at any instant you have two components, okay? It is a horizontal and vertical component. In this question, it's asked that the velocity of a projectile equal its initial velocity. Its initial velocity. Okay? Added to. If you realize that the projectile motion has two components, and these two components, the horizontal component, we can say that in the horizontal component, the particle moves with the constant velocity, right? But for the vertical component, it moves with an acceleration. This is because the acceleration in this motion is a gravitational acceleration only, and it's pointed down vertically. So it means that we have only this acceleration. Okay? So, it means that the horizontal velocity is a constant. Okay? In the question, it's asked that the velocity of a projectile equal to its initial velocity at 2. When you see the word at 2, it means that there is some change, okay? So, which component that change with time, and which component that is not change with time? You see that we have only this acceleration. For the projectile motion, we have only the gravitational acceleration that point downward, only. So, if I ask that the horizontal component, the velocity is a constant. The vertical component, the velocity change with time. So, it means that if you have the initial velocity here, the velocity at any instant is initial velocity at 2 watt, which one that change in time, okay? A, the constant horizontal velocity, is that correct? B, the constant vertical velocity, that's the vertical velocity constant. C, a constantly increasing horizontal velocity. D, a constantly increasing downward velocity. Okay, so choose the best answer from this information.
C.
I don't know. Maybe not. Okay, that is for the problem number one. Okay. For the problem number two, An object is shot from the back of a railroad freight car moving at 40 km per hour on a straight horizontal load. The launcher is aimed upward, perpendicular to the bed of the freight car. The object falls A. In front of the freight car. B. Behind the freight car. C. On the freight car. D. Either behind or in front of the freight car, depending on the initial speed of the object. In this problem, we have the freight car. On the railroad, okay? And it says that an object is shot from the back of a railroad freight car moving at 40 km on a straight horizontal load. It means that this freight car moves with the velocity of 40 km per hour. Okay? And an object is shot. An object is shot like this relative to the freight car. The object moves horizontally, but relative to the ground, what is the path of the object? What is the path of the object if you stand on the ground like this and look at the object, this object? If you look at this object, you should see the picture like this. Okay? It is because the object has the initial velocity, initial horizontal velocity, because initially the object moved with the freight car. So it means that the object has this 40 km per hour or so. So it means that if we stand on the ground, on the railroad, we should see the path of the object as a projectile, okay? With the initial velocity, the initial horizontal velocity equal to 40 km per hour. The problem does not give the initial vertical velocity, but that is not necessary, okay? Because the horizontal initial velocity of the object is equal to the horizontal velocity of the freight car. So when it moves back to the level of the freight car again, can you answer where should the object fall? In front of the freight car, it means that it will move back and fall at in front of the freight car like this, or behind the freight car, it means that it will move back and fall behind the freight car, or on the freight car, it move and move down on the freight car, maybe at the same position relative to the freight car. Or either behind or in front of the freight car, depending on the initial speed of the object. Initial speed of the object, we have the horizontal initial speed, which we know that it is 40 km per hour. We don't know the vertical. We don't know the vertical initial speed, but is that necessary? Okay, so what is the answer? give your answer on the sheet. Okay. Next, for the problem number 3, okay. Problem number 3. A soccer player kicks a log horizontally off a 40-meter high cliff into a pool of water. If the player hears the sound of the splash 3 seconds later, what was the initial speed given to the log? Assume the speed of sound in air is 343 meter per second. This problem is a little bit lengthy. It's lengthy because we have it is 3-step calculation. In this problem, อันไหนครับยังไม่ได้เลยใช่ไหมIn this problem, they say that a soccer player kicked a log horizontally off a 40-meter high cliff. So it means that we have 40 meter high cliff and a soccer player kicked a rock.Like this, okay. The part is a projectile. This part is a projectile. And it kick the log on the pool of water. If the player hear the sound of the splash 3 seconds later, it means that after he kick this log, and 3 seconds later.3 seconds later, he hear the sound of the splash when the log fall to the pool. Okay, what was the initial speed given to the log? The question is on at the.What is the initial speed that given to the log? Assume the speed of sound in air is 343 meter per second. Okay. We have to assume further on the motion of the sound. That is, the sound wave moves on a straight line from the pool to the soccer player, to the player. Okay. We assume that the sound wave moves on the straight line like this.From the pool to the player. So, how can we calculate the initial velocity? How can we calculate the initial velocity? First, can you calculate the time that this log fall into the pool, the time of flight of the log from the player to the pool? OK? Can we calculate the time of flight? If I say that this is a T1, is the time of flight that the log move from the player to the pool. ทำไมมากันกระปิดกระปอย What is the time of flight? Can we calculate? If we don't know the initial velocity v here, can we calculate the time of flight? Can we? What determine the time of flight of the projectile motion?What parameter that determine the time of flight of the projectile motion? The horizontal motion or the vertical motion? Which one determine the time of flight? The vertical motion, right? Because the vertical motion will determine the time that the particle move from the start and then fall back to the ground. So,In this situation, what is the initial velocity, the initial vertical velocity? Zero, okay? So, from this, we can determine easily the time of flight of the log, T1, okay? We have that H equal to S0 plus VY0 T plus half of GT square. Now I put the positive direction downward like this. So G is positive here. Okay? And H0is zero. แล้วยังไงกันเนี่ยไม่ค่อยโผล่มาทีละคนand y zero is zero. So and we have h is 40 meter. So from this equation we can calculate T1, right?We can calculate T1, so we get T1, the time of flight of the rock. Next, let's say that after three seconds, the player hear the sound that the sound of the splash when the rock hit the pool. This.3 seconds is the time of flight of the rock and the time of flight of the sound. If I denote the time of flight of the sound as T2, so it means that I have that T1 plus T2 is equal to T second, right?T1 is the time of flight of the log. T2 is the time of flight of the sound. The sound starts from the pool and travels to the player. And the total time is 3 seconds. Okay? So it means that if we know T1 and we know the total time is 3 seconds, we can calculate T2. Okay? Now,Once you calculate T2, can you calculate the distance from the player to the pool? Can you calculate the distance from the player to the pool? If I denote this as S, big S,at the distance from the player to the pool. Once we know T2, we can determine S, right? We can determine if we have that if is equal to the velocity of the sound time t2. Okay? And once we know if, can you determine the length of the motion r? Okay, you know h here is equal to 40 meters, and if you know this distance h, can you determine r? And once you know r, and you know the time of flight of the log, can you determine the initial velocity, initial horizontal velocity? Okay, so that is the way to solve this problem. Okay? As I told you, this is like a little bit lengthy because there's many steps to calculate this. But you can do this if you can interpret the problem correctly. Okay? So that is for the question number 3. Question number 4. A projectile aimed at angle 60 degrees to the floor, 60 degrees to the floor, to a target hang from the ceiling. When the projectile is fired with the initial speed of 10 meters per second, the target is dropped vertically. If the ceiling is 5 meters high, the projectile will hit the target at the height h, where h is equal to what? 1.63, 2.45, 3.37, and 4.01. This is shooting monkey problem, something like that. Okay. The problem is that you aim a projectile at the angle of 60 degrees and aim this to a target that hang on the ceiling, like this. The target is at 5 meter high. And when you fire the projectile with the initial speed of 10 meter per second, it means that when you fire this projectile with the initial speed of 10 meter per second, this object is dropped. This object is dropped at the moment that you fire the projectile. We can prove that if you do this, whatever the initial velocity you put to the projectile will hit the target. The projectile will hit the target for sure. But the question here is that once you fire the projectile and the object drop, and the projectile hit the target, what is the height when the projectile hit the target? What is the height when the projectile hit the target? How can you solve this problem? the information we have here is the initial velocity of the projectile. So you can calculate if I say that this is V. ยังไม่ได้อีกแล้วนี่ยังไม่ได้เหมือนกันค่อยๆมากัน I can have that I will have that Vx 0 is equal to V 0 cos theta okay whereTheta is equal to 60 degrees, okay? And we have the Vy0 is V0 sine theta. Please notice that when I solve the problem, I never put the numerical value into the equation, until I already solve or I already have the solution. I will put the numericalvalue to the equation or to the solution at the end only. This is the way that we solve the problem because it is easier to look at the equation with the symbolic. We know that this parameter is the velocity, this parameter is the angle, this parameter is the distance.And that is easier, especially when you want to interpret the physical meaning of each parameter. But if you put the numerical value to the equation, so you cannot know what is that parameter because it is just a number. So please try to do like this, that do not put the numerical value until you already have the solution. That is a better way to solve the problem. Okay, so we have that this is a initial horizontal velocity. This is a initial vertical velocity. Okay, and if I assume the time of flight of the projectile as t,assume the time of flight of the projectile of t, it means that if this is the horizontal distance from the projectile to this point, okay.If r is the horizontal distance from the projectile to the point that the object drop, if you let the object drop freely, it will hit the ground here. So I say that this is the distance r. From the information you have here, can you calculate r? Can you calculate r? You know that the ceiling is 5 meter height. You know the angle here. Can you calculate the value of r? You have that tan theta is equal to, if I put this equal to big H, this is big H, okay?So I have that tan theta is equal to h over r, okay, right? Tan theta is equal to h over r. So I have that r is equal to h over tan theta. So from the information here, we can calculate the value of r, okay? And once you have the value of r, can you calculate the time of flight? Once you know the value of r, can you calculate the time of flight? You know the horizontal is the initial horizontal velocity. Okay? Can you calculate the time of flight? We have that. We must have that R is equal to V y 0 times the time of flight, right? If the projectile hit the target here, so it means that the horizontal distance that the projectile move is R, right? So the time of flight, if the time of flight is T, so it means that we have that R must equal to the initial horizontal velocity times the time of flight. From this equation, you can calculate the time of flight, right? And once you know the time of flight, can you calculate the vertical distance, the vertical distance of the projectile? Once you know the time of flight, can you calculate the vertical distance of the projectile? You can calculate the vertical distance of the projectile, right? Or you can also calculate the vertical distance of the object once you know the time of flight, right? You can calculate that S is equal to H0 plus VY0T minus half of GT square. But you know that H0 is 0, right? You know that VY0 is V0 psi theta. Okay? I'm say something wrong before. The horizontal velocity should have to be this one. So it have, I have to change this to Vx, right? It have to be Vx, okay? Because it is a horizontal motion. So this is the Vx. Now, go back to this equation. We know that this Vy0 is V0 sine theta. And we know the gravitational acceleration. We know the time of flight. So we can calculate H, right? We can calculate H. We can also calculate this from this equal to big H plus V zero T minus right. Big S is the initial height. Big S is the initial height of the object, right? Big S is the initial height of the object. I use the big V0 here as the initial velocity of the object. This is the initial velocity of the object. And what is the initial velocity of the object? What is the initial velocity of the object? Zero, right? The object hang on the ceiling initially. So the initial velocity of the object is zero, okay? And it drops from the height of 5 meters with the acceleration G, okay? With the initial acceleration G. So we can have the position of the object. We can have the position of the object. Now, here we use the reference level. This is a reference level. Okay, this is a reference level. So, the initial position of the object is a big H. And once you minus it with a half of GT square, you can get H also. Okay? So, from this equation, you can get H. So that is for the question number 4. Okay. Next, for the question number 5. A stone is thrown from the top of a building upward at an angle of 30 degrees to the horizontal with an initial speed of 20 meters per second. The height from which the stone is thrown is 45 meters above the ground. What is the speed of the stone just before it strikes the ground? This is simple. This problem is simple. Right? You have a stone thrown at the angle of 30 degrees to the horizontal with an initial speed of 20 meters per second. Right? And it's thrown at the height of 40 meters above the ground. This is the ground, so this is the 45 meters above the ground. The trajectory of the motion is a projectile. Okay? The question is that what is the speed? What is the speed when it hit the ground, when the object hit the ground? This question is simple, but you have to be careful. The question asks for the speed. The question asks for the speed. It means that you have to calculate the magnitude of the velocity when the object hit the ground. And the velocity when the object hit the ground, if the velocity vector is like this, you have both the vertical, the horizontal and the vertical component. Okay? It's the Vx and the Vy. So you have to calculate both Vx and Vy, and then you have that V is equal to the square root of Vx square plus Vy square. Okay? Now, can you calculate Vx and Vy? This is the same problem as when we solve the question number 3, right? You have H equal to the 45 meter here. You know H, and from the information here, you know the initial velocity, right? You know Vy 0, you know Vx 0, okay? Vy 0 is equal to V psi theta. Vx 0 is equal to V 0 consider where V0 is 20 meter per second and theta is 30 degree. So you know the initial horizontal and vertical velocity. Once you know the initial horizontal and vertical velocity, you can calculate the final one if you know the time of flight. Okay, if you know the time of flight. From this information, can you answer what is the Vx? Can you know the Vx from this information? Does the horizontal velocity change during the projectile motion? The horizontal velocity does change during the projectile motion. It's not changed. So once you know this Vx0, what is the value of Vx? Once you know the Vx0, what is the value of Vx? It must equal to Vx0, right? Because the horizontal velocity does not change, okay, during the motion, the projectile motion. So once you know the initial Vx0, it must equal to the final Vx. So your task is to calculate the Vy only. You calculate the Vy only. And can you calculate the Vy? You can do this by calculate the time of flight and calculate the Vy. But you can also do this using the formula that does not need the time. What is the formula that does not need the time? We have this formula, right? V square is equal to the V0 square plus 2a y, right? For the one-dimensional motion, we have this formula. Now, if we apply this to the vertical motion, we can say that this is a Vy and this is Vy0, and we put A here, equal to G. Okay? We put the acceleration here equal to G. You know why, right? We have Y, okay, I put Y here equal to H. So you know the vertical distance, Y equal to 45 meters. You know the value of G. You know the value of Vy0. So you can calculate the value of Vy, right? The final vertical velocity. And once you know Vy here, and you know already know Vx, you can calculate the magnitude of the velocity, which is the speed of the projectile, the final speed of the projectile. Okay? So you can get the solution from here. Okay. So that is for the question number 5. Next, question number 6. Two projectiles are in flight at the same time the acceleration of one relative to the other. Okay. The keyword of this question is that it is the acceleration of one relative to the other. The acceleration, this is the relative acceleration. What is the relative acceleration? If I ask the acceleration, it means that it's the acceleration relative maybe to the ground, right? But this is the relative acceleration between these two projectiles. So it means that if you have two objects, and you stand on one object, your friend stand on the other object, and these two objects drop freely with the gravitational acceleration, and when you look at your friend or your friend look at you, what is the acceleration you will see your friend move? What is the acceleration you will see that your friend move? If you look at your friend like this, both of you drop with the acceleration g. Both of you drop with the acceleration g. This problem does not ask for the acceleration relative to the ground, but it asks for the acceleration that if you stand on one object, your friend stand on the other object, and both of you drop with the acceleration g. And when you look at your friend, what is the acceleration you see your friend move? Okay? What is the acceleration you see your friend move? Okay? So, think about this. This is a little bit tricky on this question. But the point is that this is a relative acceleration between two objects, between you and your friend. Okay? Next, question number 7. A car leaves a stop sign and exhibits a constant acceleration of 3 meter per second square parallel to the roadway. The car passes over a light in the roadway such that the top of the light is shaped like a circle of radius of 500 meters. At the moment the car is at the top of the light, its velocity vector is horizontal and has a magnitude of 6 meters per second. What is the magnitude of the total acceleration vector for the car at this instant? The problem is like this. You have a car move along a road that have a light like this. And if we approximate this light as a circle with the radius of 500 meters, I is equal to 500 meters. And they say that the car moves with a constant acceleration of 0.3 meter per second. A is equal to 0.3 meter per second square, and the car moves like this. Okay. What is the magnitude of the total acceleration vector for the car at this instant? They say that at the moment the car is at the top of the line, the velocity vector is horizontal and has a magnitude of 6 meters per second. It means that when the car is at the top, the velocity vector is horizontal and the magnitude of the velocity is 6 meters per second. You can see that in this problem, the car moves along the path that is a part of a circle. They say that the line is a path, the line is shaped like a circle. So it means that the car moves on the path, which is a part of a circle. When an object moves on a circle, we must have the centripetal acceleration, right? We must have the centripetal acceleration. The centripetal acceleration AC. And what is the formula for the centripetal acceleration? We must have that AC is equal to V square over R, right? V square over R. It means that if the car moves with this velocity and we know the radius of the circle, we can calculate the centripetal acceleration. We also call this the radial acceleration because the direction of the acceleration vector is radial, on the radial direction, point to the center of the circle. Okay? But the car also moves with the tangential acceleration of 0.3 meters per second. So at the top of the line, you can see that the car has two components of the acceleration, AC and A. Okay, I write this as AT. T stands for the tangential. Okay? So you have the acceleration vector, this AT and this AC. Can you calculate the total acceleration vector? What is the angle between these two vectors? What is the angle between these two vectors? 90 degrees, right? We know that the angle between these two vectors is 90 degrees. So you know the radial component of the acceleration. You know the tangential component of the acceleration. Can you calculate the total acceleration? This is simple, right? You have that the total acceleration is equal to the AT square plus AR square and take the square root. Okay, so this is the total acceleration because you know two components, right? You know two components. You know the horizontal component and you know, not horizontal. You know the tangential component and you know the radial component. So you can calculate the total acceleration. Okay, so this is simple. This question is quite simple. You also can calculate the direction. This is the total acceleration, right? So it means that you can calculate the angle theta here. The angle theta here. You can calculate the angle theta here, which is the question, which is in the question number 8. Okay? The question number 8 is that from the previous question, what is the direction? What is the direction of the total acceleration vector for the car at this instant? So it means that you have to calculate this angle theta. Okay, this angle theta. You know AT, you know AC. You know the angle between AC and AT is 90 degrees. So you can calculate this angle easily. Right? You can calculate this angle easily. So that is for the question number 8. Okay. Question number 9. It say that the athlete rotate a 1 kilogram discus along a circular path of radius 1.06 meter. The maximum speed of the discus is 20 meter per second. This means the magnitude of the maximum radial acceleration of the discus. Okay. This is very simple. At least rotate a discus, okay, and the radius is r is equal to 1.06 meter, and at the maximum speed is the v is equal to 20 meter per second. So you know the speed, you know the radius of the circle. It means that you can calculate the centripetal acceleration, which equal to v square over r. So this is just, you put the number to the formula and you get the solution. Okay. Now, to the last question for test 5. They say that the launch angle for the 5 paths in the figure below with respect to time of flight from the shortest time of flight to the longest. Okay? We have 5 paths. Okay. We have 5 paths like this. The number here is the initial, the angle of the initial velocity to the ground. For all these paths, the initial velocity, the magnitude of the initial velocity are equal for all these 5 paths. The magnitude of the initial velocity are all equal. But the difference is the angle to the ground, the angle of the velocity vector to the ground. So, what is the time of flight? Which one did mean the time of flight? We have already discussed this. The time of flight. The time of flight is determined from the what? Horizontal velocity or the vertical velocity? The time of flight. Which one did mean the time of flight? Once you know the initial velocity, you know the direction, the angle of the velocity vector to the ground. You can determine the horizontal velocity. You can determine the vertical velocity. Which one determines the time of flight? Okay? The vertical velocity determines the time of flight, right? So, all of these five parts have the same initial velocity, but the different angle. Can you determine which one will have the longest time of flight, which one will have the shortest time of flight? Okay, so that is for the question number 10. Now I will allow you to do the detailed calculation for this 10 questions. Okay, so start, do it.